all know, and those that I don't, I hope at some point my staff or I get a chance to get to know you better. Now that Jack is coming, Jack's a good friend of mine, I think the way we punish him is we let none of our players go to any of you. Now, we keep them here in the valley, okay? I'll share a couple up with her, but let's keep them at Grand Canyon. You know, I've been at Grand Canyon now 3 years. We started year four. And since 1997, Grand Canyon has only had 500 seniors, and we've been fortunate to have three of them. Now, there's some factors involved there. The commitment they made when I came with scholarship money, buildings, and everything else has aided in that. Out of our 16 players, 12 of them are from the state of Arizona. And that's very important to us because one of the things when I was at Arizona State, Arizona, I always thought that the Valley was under-recruited. And while we don't have a lot of high major players every year compared to Los Angeles and New York, some of those bigger cities, we have always had good, solid, mid-major plus people. And when I was recruiting from those two schools, I'd always think about, man, if I had a job that this would work, I would really recruit Phoenix. And we've been very fortunate that at GCU we've been able to keep some of the better local talent at home. Saying that, I believe this. And this is why I'm so committed to this day. Defense, we're always here. Defense wins championships. Offense, they sell tickets. Defense wins championships. My first 3 years at Grand Canyon, we've been in the top three in field goal percentage defense. Last year, we were second by 0.2 points. And we were number one in the league in three-point defense against. We also, it doesn't take away from your offense, we led the league in scoring. We led the league in scoring margin. But the whole premise of what we do is on the defensive end. Today what I'm going to talk about is really share with you some of the things that I've learned over the years. My first, experience with defense was playing for my father. He's here today, doing Pennell. And my dad was kind of a disciple of Eddie Sutton. Loved Coach Sutton, loved what he did. Used to work the basketball camps at Arkansas. We're back from the Midwest, and we used to go down there, and Dad, spent a lot of time with Eddie Sutton, Gene Cady, Pat Foster, kind of some of the saltiest coaches to ever walk the planet. And so that was kind of our MO at the high school in Kansas where I grew up. And we got the stance, we got the passing lane, and we got after. And then I had the good fortune when I went to college to go to the University of Arkansas and play for Coach Sutton. And then I learned even more about defense. And guys, this is before shot clock. So you can't even imagine. I know Coach Ballard had you guys play defense. We used to play without a shot clock. You might be on defense 25 minutes sometimes before somebody takes a shot. And it was difficult. But what I learned through that is this. You're staunch on defense. If you make a commitment to that, you always have a chance to win a game. Now, here's what I do believe. We're all, this time of the year, you can get about anybody to sign on for defense. I know with me, in the offseason, in the summer, and even till now, I can get my assistants to get me to listen to about anything. But then what happens, we usually migrate right back to what we're comfortable with. And I understand that. We say defense is the most important thing, but I would challenge you on this. Look at your practice plans. Look at your practice schedules. Once you've got them laid out, look and see if your emphasis is on defense. Because here's the thing. You'll tell your teams, we got to be great defensively. And then your practice plan won't reflect that. You'll have 70% offense and about 30% defense. I would say in our practices, we're about 60-40 on the defensive side. And we spend a ton of time on what people call shell defense. They have a different name for it. And a lot of different drills. But we put the emphasis on that. Here's how much I emphasize defense. I don't care how good you can score. If you won't play defense, I won't play you. You say, oh, coach, come on. You guys might put it in the basket and average 20 a game. Won't do it. Because here's what happens. If I compromise for one, I got to compromise the rest of them. And so defense is a constant. We all play defense. We all get the stance. We all give great effort on defense, or I will not play you. Now, the good part of that is over the course of time, if you've been in school for a while, probably your kids know that. And you don't have to worry about that too much, that you get them to defend. A couple other thoughts, and then I'm going to get to the, kind of the crux of it here for you all, is this. I would say this. I'm going to talk about pressure man-to-man defense. I told you I played for Coach Sutton, and then I worked for Ed Sutton at Oklahoma State. Our first staff was myself, Robin Evans, Bill Self, Jimmy Dice of ESPN. That was our first staff at Oklahoma State. And Coach Sutton was a just, I thought, one of the best defensive coaches of all time. Now, let me tell you where that came from for you that are basketball historians. Coach Sutton played for Henry Ivey, also known as Mr. Ivey. He was alive when I was at Oklahoma State. He used to come to our practices all the time. For some of you younger ones, Henry Ivey was the only coach we've ever had for our Olympic team until 1980. He was part of that Munich debacle in Germany in 1972. They kept good time in the box till the Russians won. That we're all still bitter about when I was a little kid. And Mr. Ivey was a mentor to Bob Knight. A lot of Bobby Knight's defense came from Henry Ivey, which then Bobby Knight passed on Mike Krzyzewski. So when you see that family tree, most of that came from Henry Ivey.